minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. We've gone for main engine start.
Launch of Columbia, a fantastic flying machine, but still a machine that will only perform as well as we perform while it's on the ground. This is course OV211, payload bay and aft access familiarization, and it's designed to familiarize you with ingress, egress, safety procedures, and work habits in the payload bay and aft section of the orbiter. It all starts here, at the OPF, or Orbiter Processing Facility, where safety and teamwork are a must. Let's go inside and see where we begin. The Operations Control Center is our first stop. All persons wishing to enter the orbiter, whether contractor personnel or visitors, must obtain clearance from the operations engineer. His job is to coordinate all work in and around the orbiter. So for your safety and the safety of others, you must not enter the payload bay or aft section without that clearance. Read and recognize all area warning and instruction signs, such as this one, which instructs you to tape or tether all hand tools, eyeglasses, jewelry, and all items must be removed from upper pockets before entering any work platform around the orbiter. Or this could happen to you. Our next step before entering the payload bay or aft section is to sign in on the proper access log. When taking items such as test equipment on board, they must be signed in on the ingress egress sheet equipment log. All chemicals must be signed in on the hazardous chemicals control log. Chemical quantities are limited, so refer to the pre-flight operations procedure located at the Operations Control Center. When personnel only are entering the orbiter and are not taking chemicals or equipment on board, the personnel ingress egress sheet must be signed. Remember, the orbiter is an aircraft. Weight and balance are important. So a shuttle weight log will be maintained to record the hardware and materials removed, installed, or relocated. And don't forget to place your employee badge in the rack. The payload bay is designed to carry highly sophisticated equipment, and most require clean room standards. Garments such as this one, which have been dubbed the bunny suit, is a coverall type garment and must be worn inside the payload bay, along with soft rubber-soled shoes or sneakers, and booties must be worn. There are several ways to enter the payload bay. The 44 door, which is located on the left side of the orbiter, just above the wing glove. The right-hand wheel well door. A ladder mounted to the temporary work platforms. And the crew module airlock. The ladder and airlock are not normal ingress-egress routes. However, in certain configurations or in an emergency, they can be used. The orbiter must be constructed of lightweight materials. The lighter we can make it and still maintain strength and stability, the heavier the payload. This is a structural support called a boron tube. It's made of boron fibers that are formed into a tubular shape, then saturated with a resin, very similar to fiberglass, but extremely lightweight. The load-carrying capabilities of a boron tube are from end to end, but if pressure is applied to the middle, such as using it for a step, a handhold, or to lean on, it can be broken and must be replaced, which is very expensive and time-consuming. This is a line support isolator, or milk stool, as some call it. It's made of fiberglass and strong enough for its intended purpose, but not to stand on. The cold plate is an evaporator type heat exchanger and used for cooling electronic equipment and takes no effort at all to damage. Almost everywhere you look in the payload bay or aft fuselage, you'll find electrical cables and connectors. This one has been damaged due to the careless placement of a work platform. But this one has been properly sealed and tethered. And you must never use something like this as a handhold. Breakout boxes and other test equipment must be tethered to prevent accidents. Watch out for liquid and high pressure gas lines. When working in an open payload bay, bridge buckets and overhead cranes may be in use. And observe platform weight limits. Cleanliness is of great importance. One small particle of dust or dirt could cause serious damage to a payload and possible failure of the mission. It's the responsibility of each person entering the orbiter to inspect their immediate work area for any type of contamination. And if present, notify your supervision so action can be taken. Now let's talk about the aft fuselage. Access to the aft can be obtained through the 50-1 door or 50-2 door. For your safety while in the aft, an alarm has been installed. This alarm has a red beacon and warble horn. This device is fully automatic, and when it senses a low oxygen level in the aft, the alarm will sound. This is your cue to get out via the nearest egress route. Also, there is a box like this one just outside the aft, containing breathing escape units. And there are 10 of these units inside the aft, located on the lowest level. If an emergency should occur, they contain enough breathing air for you to get out safely. Once inside the aft, you'll see there's not much room for volleyball. Great care must be taken so that you don't damage fuel, hydraulic, or high-pressure gas lines. Be conscientious. Report any discrepancy you might see so they can be properly tagged and corrected. And as in the payload bay, all equipment taken in the aft must be tethered. Now let's go back and double check some things. Remember to check in at the Operations Control Center. Observe all warning and instruction signs. Tether hand tools, eyeglasses. Remove everything from upper pockets. Sign in on the proper access log. Remember to put on the proper clothing when in the payload bay. The bunny suit. Access to the payload bay. And be extremely careful when working around boron tubing. Milk stools. Tether all test equipment. Watch out for bridge buckets and overhead cranes. Be aware of the alarm in the aft. Breathing escape units. Know where they're located. Check for loose or damaged items and tag them properly. You know, sometimes things have a habit of becoming routine. But don't let that happen to you. Be conscientious. Be safety-minded, because you are a part of the entire mission. The return of these men depends on you.